So let's take a look at our own Continuum CRM data quality dashboard project. So as I said, this is something we did internally for ourselves because we have got a hub, we use HubSpot. That's our CRM, right? That's where we keep log of perhaps some of your names, our lovely clients, our deals, everything like that to make sure we can run our business effectively, right? But when we try to do sort of mail outs and quotes and invoicing all from the CRM, we ran into a bit of an issue. We found out that sometimes some of the contact information, such as the names and the addresses, the company numbers, all that sort of stuff, was missing. So how can we effectively, one, not just remediate it, right, but make sure it's consistently kept on top of so we can make sure the quality in our CRM is kept to a high standard to allow our own business operations internally at Continuum to run a little bit smoothly. And this is how we did it. So I'm just to show you guys our journey in that respect. So why is data quality important? Well, of course, you need to make complete data sets to make decisions, informed decisions effectively, right? If I've got incomplete or incorrect data, I can't have a good, clear view about what's going on within my business. Of course, that's very important. We like to demonstrate people this nice little Dell maturity model in terms of data maturity. It all starts off here with data aware, being people with sort of manually compiling non-standardized reports, which tends to where most people tend to find themselves, erring into the data proficiency stage when they start to get standardized reports, the likes of Alteryx and things like that, getting things rerunnable. Data savvy is when business data is utilized in all business decisions, and data-driven, maybe when you're looking forward to some of that machine learning, predictive analytics, where data is really driving the business and all those decisions. So we wanted to move ourselves up that data maturity scale somewhat. And of course, we use our data from our CRM for quotes, for invoices, for mail-outs. So a lot of you guys right here will be recipients of some of these yourselves. And our sales pipeline and cash flow forecasting would be misleading. Of course, we do that via our CRM as well to see what deals are in the pipeline and what we can expect coming in to help with our own business intelligence somewhat. And of course, we can see that's what we might expect it to be. In actual fact, it might deviate somewhat. But of course, the data was telling us an incorrect story. So that's kind of the premise of why I really wanted to improve this. So what is bad data quality? Here's some snapshots. We got first and last name. You know what I mean? I can't send a mail out to this guy. He'll say, hi, comma. Do you know what I mean? That doesn't look very good, perhaps. Doesn't stand well to our company reputation. Contact owner. So within the organization, I manage some clients, George Manasum, Dan, and so on. So who's going to be the representative for that particular client? And of course, if any actions need to be taken on that client, then who do we contact? We don't know. They haven't got a contact owner assigned. No email, no country, no region. So that's important when we're inviting all of you guys to like to this meeting. We only really want to invite Jersey guys to come down. We've got lots of international lovely clients. We don't want to invite them to an in-person event in Jersey. It's a little bit embarrassing, right? It's like we're in the UK or in Europe or something like that. So again, we need to have that there and some address information, really important for quotes and invoicing and all that sort of stuff. We want to generate them at the CRM as well. So this is what we're faced with. How do we get better? So moving across, this is our solution slide. So we start with HubSpot, that's our CRM, right? We've got some APIs that come out of HubSpot, which you can connect Alteryx to by the download tool. We developed some macros within Alteryx ourselves to go ahead and pull out information such as company contacts, companies, the deals, and the Continuum owners who owns those contacts. We bring them into Alteryx, of course, join them all together, cleanse them up, standardize them, and we set ourselves some business rules and some priorities to make sure that we know what the issue is and, of course, how important that issue is as well. And what we do then is we push it into an SQL data store, so we're persisting all of that data, and we've got then what's known as a direct query to our very own Power BI dashboard. And the benefit of that then is, rather than having outputs from Alteryx into Excel, for example, you'd have to go into Power BI dashboard and click refresh to pull that data through. However, since we're pushing it from HubSpot, click run on Alteryx, comes out of here through into the SQL dashboard, and then via that direct query, it's got that synchronization that happens automatically between the SQL server and the dashboard. So as soon as you open that dashboard, the new results are already there, ready for you to look at. And of course, we use Alteryx Auto Insights as well. We've got it, why not? So this is a brief video of some of the things we've got some of our issues. So this is kind of the export that we've got from our Alteryx workflow, which is a little bit fuzzy right now, but hopefully that's gonna resolute in a little bit to show us who the company is, what the issue is, and all that sort of good stuff. Here's our lovely workflow, of course, containerized, colored, adhering to those MOCWO standardization rules. Each one has different contacts and things like that, and that effectively outputs the data into Alteryx Auto Insights to not only show us what the data is, but to show us some trends into what's happening with some of our data. This is like a nice little mail out that the whole team gets every morning. We see how many new issues there are, how many since last week, who are the culprits? Perhaps we'll see who the biggest one is in a moment. And we can go see a variety of other different things. This is actually the video that Dan demonstrated at his Alteryx Inspire presentation, by which he spoke over it somewhat. But effectively, in the interest of time, I'm just going to show you the dashboard that we've got here. So what we've got is our lovely dashboard. This is the result, effectively, right? And what we can have to notice is we've embedded it in Teams as well, right? Makes it a little bit more effective for us to interact with and share around all the different people. And what we've got here is a number of issues, lovely little trend downwards, which is good. People have been actually taking some action to remediate some of those issues, see who the owners of these issues are. I've only got 11%, so not too bad on my behalf, not some for others. We've got a number of issues by type, mate, so expired close date on a deal. Do you know what I mean? The close date's gone, that needs to be updated. Long time in current stage, so maybe it's been just as a prospect stage for ages, someone needs to go ahead and update that. And that's showing us just some overview of some of these issues that we've got here. What I might also point your attention to is some of these narrative. It's a new feature in Power BI. It actually creates some of that narrative automatically for you to show you some of the different trends. The number of issues trended down, number of issues start trending up on Thursday. You start to get a little bit more insight. We didn't create that. That's our Power BI going ahead and creating some of those insights for you. There we go. So here we go. For example, myself, I've got a deal with an expired close date, and this is object priority one. That's very important. We've got a deal that hasn't got a date on it. However, it's a company priority three and an issue priority five. So I can now just start to rank those, which is important in terms of the object, which is important in terms of our company and in terms of the issues, to make sure I'm fixing and remediating those top priority issues first, rather than going and filling a load of stuff that didn't really have that much of an impact. I can have a look at the stuff that's a little bit more prevalent. And what we've got is we've got auto-generated the URL for that particular page. So if I want to go ahead and update that, I can click onto there, and that's going to go navigate me to that particular page or deal within the HubSpot CRM, and I'll go ahead and change that back into here. And then I'll just make a practice of this every week, every Friday. Come in, just go ahead and whittle down your deals and whittle down your issues until you get it down to zero. So that's kind of how we're utilizing our own methodology internally, right? We're preaching it to all you guys, yeah, go do this, but we didn't really follow that internally until we've now spent a little bit of effort doing this, and it's now an opportunity for one, it's a use in production, it helps us out, but also a nice showcase, nice use case to show you how this will all function. So going from source via an API to Alteryx, to SQL data store, and then that synchronization to a Power BI dashboard that we can see right here to allow us to see on top of that.
Yeah, and I think the key point is, first of all, transparency. I don't think we knew some of the issues that we actually had internally until we start to visualize them, right? And then secondly, you've got the orchestration of, you know, how do you fix those? And then we obviously put this dashboard in, there's a hyperlink, it takes you straight to the company or the deal or whatever object it is to try and remediate that data. And I think those two points together, obviously orchestrated by Alteryx, that really sort of drives that data quality improvement.
Quite right, and of course we leverage our own Alteryx server, so therefore this is run every day at 2 in the morning. But we've also got, can I go onto the KPIs page, your little dashboard refresh button? That's in there, I've got to check now what button I click on, jeez. All right, so we've also got this little button here, which is pretty cool, right? I'm not going to do it justice, but Teo, could you kindly just explain, he's the genius behind it, all right, man over there. Can you tell us how this button works? Pretty cool.
Yeah, so that kicks off some Power Automate in the background, which actually calls our server to run a workflow, which updates all the data that we need to, that takes about 45 seconds, and then you can crash data.
Nice. So yeah, we're going to go ahead, click onto the button, and that's going to go and query, call an API to then kick off the server job, which refreshes the dashboard, gets into the SQL database, and have that synchronization popping up here. So it takes about 45 seconds to go ahead and refresh that. So if I make some changes, I want to see what effect that's had. I want to see my part of the segment shrink down somewhat. Click onto the refresh, I can see the results of my efforts, perhaps. Right, Office 365 and Alteryx, what a power duo.